Welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate, and today we're going to be talking about the Wildwood Xlight 201BHXL. This is a really cool product because they just made some big, huge upgrades on it this year. Let me talk about a few things on this side, on the outside, and then we'll go on the inside. This has a power awning, power stabilizer jacks, power tongue jack. You'll notice too, they've put in this new light strip that you can control what color the awning lights are going. It has a nice size window, outside speakers, pass-through storage all the way through that you can access from either underneath the couch as well. Let's walk around to the front here and I'll show you a couple of cool features over here. I love the power tongue jack because you do have the ability to turn on an LED light to see what you're doing as you're hooking up or unhooking, because you're not always doing that during the daytime. This is 40 mil aluminum, so instead of having the corrugated front like a lot of guys do, this has the smoother front for more aerodynamic, and it'll take a lot more hits without dinging it. And then you'll notice too that this diamond plate is raised up a lot higher than what most guys do as well. The power tongue jack just makes it easy so that you're not cranking it back and forth all the time, especially if you put an equalizer hitch or a weight distribution hitch on here. You have to raise it up and down a couple times before you get it just right. So this makes that a lot easier process. There is an override if you ran out of battery or if it stopped working, you can do it manually as well. Another cool thing is, even though this is a smaller unit, it's a tandem axle. So that means you're going to have a lot better pull as you're running down the road. And that means it's going to be a lot more stable than a single axle. These tires are nitrogen filled tires so that they will brake better, handle better. The tread life will last a lot longer. And then these are the easy lube axles. So instead of having to repack the bearings every time, you can pull that rubber off, grease just the zerk, and then you're good to go again for a little while, so you're not having to repack your bearings as much. This also has a outside, or a hot water heater I should say, and this is a gas hot water heater that has the DSI function in it. So instead of having to come out here and light the pilot light, especially if it's windy and it blows your pilot light out and you're coming back out here, this one has a switch on the inside that you just push and it'll automatically light it for you. It's a 6 gallon tank with a 10.2 gallon refresh rate per hour. To mention on the camper here is it has two 20 pound propane tanks, and it has an auto changeover regulator built into it. So once it runs out of gas on one propane tank, it'll automatically switch it over to the second one. The nice thing about the 20 pound tanks is that you can switch them at any gas station or King Soopers or Walmart, something like that, as opposed to having to fill them up at like an RV place. So if you're out camping out in the mountains and there's, you know, a place that does the Rhino exchange type thing, you can do that here. I also like that this cover has the little lid on the top too, so you can switch them on and off over here instead of having to take that whole cover off each time you need to do something. Let's go ahead and take a look inside and see what's going on in here. One of the nice things that they've upgraded to is the new bow floor. This is, instead of a normal linoleum, it's more of kind of like a rubbery feel. And the benefits are it's cold crack resistant, slip resistant, stain resistant, and mold and mildew resistant. So what I see a lot of times in campers that have linoleum is where they cut the linoleum bad, or where it starts to shrink, especially during the winter time, it will crack usually right down in the weakest spot, which is in the middle of the camper, because it's trying to pull both directions as it shrinks. You can imagine trying to replace linoleum, and campers are very expensive because you're removing lots of parts. And so if you can get something that has a bow floor where it's a little bit more forgiving, you're better off. Inside here, you'll notice that we have the high-rise sink faucet. So even if you put in a big pan or something like that, you can still get around the sink here, and it's a double sink. You'll notice there's mini blinds over here instead of just the curtains. And also it has a wood blind over here by the dinette, so a little bit nicer, more residential look to it. And if you look, this is a huge size window as well that you're working with. This dinette turns into a bed, as well as this couch over here. And then this is a countertop extension that folds up and down. So if you needed a little bit more counter space, you have it. My favorite things about this camper is the Murphy bed. So I wanted to show you how this works. So I'm gonna take off these pillows real quick. This couch just folds flat into a bed, and you can also access your storage underneath here as well from the pass-through storage. But you have a couple latches right here. And then this guy just folds down. So it's that easy to make your bed. You'll notice you still have some extra storage up here, as well as storage on both sides and mirrors on both sides as well. And then it's just as easy to fold up and put away as well. And the beauty of this is it takes all of 5 seconds to put this back together, and you're not taking up a bed, you know, when really all you need this is at nighttime anyway. The rest of the daytime, it'd be nice to keep your length a little bit down and then have somewhere to sit. So that's a great feature about this one. We have this dinette that folds into a bed. The other cool thing that I like about these is this is more of like a vinyl material, so it's easy to clean up. So if you're wearing your wet trunks or something like that, you can even flip them over if you wanted to use the not as nice side, so that if it's spaghetti night or something like that and you don't want to get all your stuff stained or dirty. This folds into a bed. Two adults can fit on here. You also have the bed in the front, as well as these bunk beds back here. So you can sleep a total of 6 people in here very comfortably. This also has the ducted air conditioner, as opposed to just a little sidewall mount air conditioner. That's going to give you a lot more. This has about twice the cooling ability as those sidewall coolers that you see sometimes on these campers. And then the other thing I really like about this is it's ducted, so it's going to cool down the unit more evenly. And another thing that's going to keep your unit more cooler is these LED lights. So not only do they use about a tenth of the power that a normal incandescent light does, they only run at about 78 degrees as opposed to 200. The problem with that is when you turn on a few of those in the middle of the night when it's still pretty warm outside, it's just going to warm up your camper that much more. This camper also comes with a built-in stereo with the DVD player built into it. A lot of them, they skip the DVD player, and you can control the inside speakers, the outside speakers, or turn them both on at the same time, and you get to choose. It also has the auxiliary port, so if you have an iPod or a smartphone, you can plug right into there to play some of your music right off your phone. Okay, you'll see that I'm in one of the lower bunks here. I'm about 6 foot tall, and you can see I still have plenty of room to roll around and headroom and things like that. So you can rest assured that your kids are going to be able to fit in here for years to come, and you're not going to outgrow this as quickly. You also have this top bunk, and this is rated for 200 pounds. I'll show you a couple things in this bathroom that stand out to me. One, it has a skylight in this ceiling. Not everybody does that. As well as this has a medicine cabinet. Instead of just a mirror that's screwed onto the wall, it actually has a place to store stuff. You also have storage underneath here. And even more space over here. So they've utilized the space really well. And then this is a tub, so if you have some small kids, they can still take a little bath here. A couple other things that I wanted to mention to you is the construction of Wildwood. They have, I feel like, one of the best construction methods for anything in this price point. They use 5/8 inch tongue and groove plywood decking instead of OSB chipboard. So that means if you're going to have a leak on the floor where you overflood the shower or bust the line or something like that, you're not going to completely ruin your subfloor underneath your camper. And you can imagine that can ruin the entire value of the camper because it's really expensive to replace a subfloor. Another thing that's really cool about these guys is they have studs every 16 inches, just like a house, and an additional frame around every single door and window. So it has a really good construction for the walls. And then the ceiling on the top of the roof, it's a truss ceiling, and so it's rounded on the top, so if you have water or something like that, it's not going to just stay there, it's going to go off to the edges. Again, just protecting your investment in what you're buying. Thanks for visiting us here on the Wildwood 201 BHXL. We are the Great Outdoors RV Company, located in Greeley, Colorado, just about an hour north of Denver. So come visit us at our website, thegreatoutdoorsrv.com.